In this video, we're going to learn how to do basic algebra with matrices. That means adding matrices, multiplying by scalars, and multiplying matrices. So let's talk about just adding two matrices. So let me give you some examples with 2x2 matrices. So let's add, say, A, B, C, D, plus a matrix E, F, G, H. Okay, so add two 2x2 matrices. It's very simple. All you have to do is add each of the components. So this would just be A plus E, B plus F, C plus G, and D plus H. Okay, so you just add the components of the elements of the matrix. Okay, another easy one is multiplication by a scalar. So let's multiply a matrix by a scalar called K. So here, K times A, B, C, D. This is also very easy. It's just K gets multiplied each of the elements. So we just have K, A, K, B, K, C, K, D. Okay. The tricky thing about matrices are actually multiplying two matrices. So let's multiply two 2x2 matrices. So here we have, say, A, B, C, D times E, F, G, H. So you might think that you can multiply each of the elements separately. The mathematical software called MATLAB actually has an operation that lets you do that. But in general, when you do matrix multiplication, you have to do it very specially. And let me illustrate here with the 2x2 times 2x2 case. What you do is you go across the first row, you go across the rows of the first matrix and down the columns of the second matrix. So here, this first element would be across the first row of the first matrix down the first column of the second matrix. So it would be A, E plus B, G. Then the element in the first row, second column, would be across the first row of the first matrix down the second column of the second matrix. So that would be A, F plus B, H. Okay? Then the element in the second row, first column, would be across the second row down the first column, so C, E plus D, G. And finally, the last element would be C, F plus D, H. Okay, so a matrix multiplication is a little bit tricky, but once you get the hang of it, it's quite simple. An interesting thing about matrices that is actually very important is that they don't commute under multiplication. So if we change the order here, so let's say we did E, F, G, H times A, B, C, D. You know, if these matrices were numbers, you would get the same result. But matrices are not numbers. So we have to follow the same rule of arithmetic here, and let's see what we get. Here we have, so usually you write the element, the matrix on the left, you write the element on the left. But, you know, regular multiplication commutes. So just to be able to make a comparison, let me keep the alphabetical order here. So it would be AE plus CF. And then it would be BE plus DF. And then second row, first column, AG plus CH. And then finally, BG plus DH. Okay? We can look at these two matrices. Are they the same? No. You get this ones are the same, and Let's see here, this is the same. But other than that, these are two very different matrices. Okay, so matrices do not commute. That's very important to remember. Okay, so as you saw when we did matrix multiplication, we went across the columns of the first matrix and down the rows of the second matrix. So what does that mean? So the first matrix might be m by n, right? And then what size matrix can we multiply an m by n matrix by? So we're going across the columns, right? When you have the first row and then you go across the column, so that means we're going across the n columns. So we're fixing the row, going across the n columns, and then going down the same number of rows. So the second matrix has to have the same number of rows as the first matrix has columns. So this is very important for matrix multiplication. And then the number of columns here is free. So the first matrix can have an arbitrary number of rows, and the second matrix can have an arbitrary number of columns. But the number of columns of the first matrix have to match the number of rows of the second matrix. Okay, it's a little bit tricky. But then if you do this properly, then you end up with a matrix which is M by P, right? M by P. Okay, so for theoretical purposes, it's useful to have a formula for matrix multiplication. So if we have two matrices, say we have C, which is a product of two matrices, A and B, it would be nice to have a formula for the matrix elements of C. So what we do is we call them little c, right? And let's say we're looking at the element in the ith row and the jth column. So we're looking at C, I, J. How do we get the element in the ith row and the jth column? So we're going across the ith row of the first matrix, which is the A matrix, and down the jth column of the second matrix, which is the B matrix. And we're multiplying them, right? So I'm going to use this symbol for summation. That means you sum. So the first element is A, right? The second element is B. And where are we on the matrix, right? The first one, we're going across the ith row. So I put a subscript I. And the second matrix, we're going down the jth column. So the second index of B should be J. And then we're making a product of A against B as we go down the ith row, as we go across the ith row and down the jth column. So this second index here, I can say K. And this first index here, I can say K. And then we're summing from K equals 1 up to how many we have here. So this is supposed to be M by N times N by P. So we have N columns of the first matrix and N rows of the second matrix. So we sum from K equals 1 to N. So this is a general formula then for the IJ element of the C matrix coming from the product of two matrices, A and B, where A is M by N and B is N by P. So we have to sum over this middle, right? So this is the key here that we're summing over these indices. Okay, so what have we done? So we've defined addition and multiplication for matrices. So adding matrices, they have to be the same dimension, right? For this definition to make sense, matrices added together have to be the same dimension, and you just add them element by element. You can multiply any matrix by a scalar. You just multiply all the elements by a scalar. And then you can multiply matrices. You go across the columns of the first matrix and down the rows of the second matrix, and you get these product formulas, okay? And here is a general formula for the element of a product matrix. Very useful for theoretical reasons, okay? I'm Jeff Chasnoff. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.